Hi again, everyone. Scott Pyre, Pop Cult Fan here, and I am finally going to cap off my series of Star Wars movie reviews with the newest film that was just released last Friday, but I saw it yesterday with my best friend Sean, aka Cash of Oz, and I am finally going to give my review for the movie. Now, this movie, The Last Jedi, I still like Force Awakens a little more, but this one, oh boy. This movie easily has some of the best acting in a Star Wars movie since the original trilogy. The acting in this movie is that good. Like, Adam Driver as Kylo Ren, he easily has the best character arc in this movie, as well as Rey and Luke. And those three characters are, like, the central characters in this movie. Although, the one thing about this movie that I don't like is the whole story with Finn's character, with this new character Rose, and that, oh boy, the planet that they go to, what the hell, it's called Cantobite, and oh boy, it looks a little too much like Earth. I just don't really like that part of the movie. It reminds me of Return of the Jedi, like with the Jabba Palace. It's just out of place. I mean, I get that it's there because it connects to everything else. it's off, you know? It feels out of place in this movie. The whole side story between Finn and this new character, Rose, while relevant to what happens later in the film, is just unnecessary. And even at the end of the film, there's a certain moment between Finn and Rose that I didn't really have any feelings about. And I'm pretty sure Finn felt the same way about that moment. I don't think... Okay, cut that out. Alright. It's just that whole part of that movie, of this movie, it bogs it down. It sort of slows the movie down a little bit. It feels like a different movie when we're watching Finn and this new character Rose in this, at this other planet. It feels like I'm watching a different short movie within this other movie. And that just bogs the movie down for me. And then there are a few moments in this movie that do disappoint me just a little. Because as a longtime Star Wars fan, you grow attached to certain things. And while necessarily I thought most of the aspects about this movie I actually appreciated, like, some of the new changes to the Force, like, to the Jedi lore, I actually appreciated. None of that bothered me. It was just a few... What they did with Snoke, I mean, while it was significant to Kylo Ren's character, what they did with Snoke was disappointing to me. They could have done a whole lot more with Snoke, and... Nope. It's disappointing. I really wanted to see where the Snoke character would have gone. I wanted him to be a different character than the Emperor. But in the end, what happened to him is basically what happened to the Emperor. They could have done a whole lot more with Snoke. That's just a little disappointment I have, as well as my favorite lightsaber getting destroyed. My favorite lightsaber that I've grown attached to for so long got wrecked. I mean, I loved that scene. You know, everything about Rey and Kylo in this movie I love, but I was just disappointing to see my favorite lightsaber get wrecked like that. God damn it. Damn it. It's hard to talk about, I've already spoiled moments in the movie, god damn it. Damn it. So, The Last Jedi, it's just a really good movie, and I just spoiled a few moments. Sorry about that. I can't talk about those moments, because they're just very, they're spoilery, and I want to give my thoughts on this movie. You know, I may as well just do a spoiler review, because it's hard to talk, it's really hard to give my thoughts on this movie without spoiling it, because the aspects of this movie, they're hard to, you can't really talk about it if you're trying to do a spoiler-free review. So I'm just gonna throw it all out there, okay? So, all right, Luke dies at the end, but he dies peacefully, watching the sun rise. I thought that was a very powerful moment. Oh my god. And Snoke dies, Kylo kills his master, so he could be the master. Yoda appears to Luke. I'm just gonna throw all the spoilers out there because I just can't talk about this movie without. I want to give my full thoughts on this movie. Sorry. I gotta talk about spoilers. I loved the scene with Yoda. Oh my god. I loved that they brought back the puppet and not used CGI. There's like this whole arc with the new Rose character, as well as the actress Laura Dern. She also plays a new character. I forget her character's name though. She tries to sacrifice herself for the resistance. Let's see. A lot happens, like a lot of changes to like Force abilities, like Luke's ability to create a matter, like he like transport, like he like astral projects himself in like on another side of the galaxy when Kylo is assaulting that giant wall that's protecting the resistance survivors. And there's this whole thing with Luke projecting an astral projection version of himself to hide the fact that he's not truly there, but he is there. I thought that was intriguing. That was like a new aspect to Force abilities that I actually really liked, and especially the whole thing between Kylo and Rey and how they're somehow sensing each other and talking to each other, and that was actually Snoke doing that. But even though Snoke was doing that, he was the one creating those that's odd like communicating effect with Kylo and Rey. Although I feel like they might continue that in the next film. So it'll be interesting to see that. And of course, because now that Snoke and Luke are dead, they'll probably come back as Force ghosts in episode 9. And it'll be interesting to see how Luke, as a Force ghost, will guide Rey while she's training, but also might be taunting Kylo Ren as a Force ghost, as well as Snoke. And that'll, like, continue that conflict in Kylo's mind of whether or not, you know, he's a of what he's tr his goal is, you know. He's not clear on his goal, and that's what makes him such a compelling character in this new trilogy, is that he's just so conflicted, and that's really what Anakin should have been in Re Revenge of the Sith. But just everything about this movie I loved. It's just the Canto Bight sequence with Finn and Rose just was not interesting. It wasn't wasn't compelling at all. It just threw me out of the movie. It felt like a different experience. I enjoyed the porgs in this movie. They're very cute. Oh my god. There's a lot of new creatures in this movie. And there's like this new like horse looking creature in the Canto Bight on the Canto Bight planet that looks like a cross between a horse and a donkey. There's also that crystal fox creature, and that's in that little cave that they're with the resistance. They remind me of Pokemon for some reason. They look like, I think they don't name the creatures in the movie, but I think they're called like Vulpix. And again, sounds very much like a Pokemon. And also Kanto Bight, you know, the planet that Finn and Rose are on is named after Kanto, the Kanto region in Japan, while also being a region in the Pokemon world. So that's interesting. So yeah, I love this movie. It's just there's a full 20 minutes dedicated to this other story that is relevant to what happens later in the story, but it's just felt very unnecessary. And that's my review, I guess. That's really all, I guess. Sorry, I know I fully spoiled the movie, but I can't give my thoughts on this movie without talking about these moments because they're just so significant to my thoughts on this movie. And a lot of fans are probably going to be disappointed because of some aspects changed to Jedi lore and to Force and to how the Force is used. I'm sure fans will be disappointed with that, but I wasn't. I thought it was really intriguing. I thought it was really cool. It's just a few things I was disappointed by. My favorite lightsaber was destroyed. I mean, I loved that moment between Kylo and Rey. I just, oh, my favorite lightsaber was destroyed. And Snoke just dying like that. They could have done a whole lot more with his character. So overall, I still like Force Awakens more than this one, but again, the acting in this movie is incredible. Mark Hamill as Luke is one of his best performances since the original trilogy. Oh my goodness. So those are my full and complete thoughts on Star Wars Episode 8, The Last Jedi. I know I spoiled the movie, but I can't give my thoughts on the movie without talking about those moments. So sorry. So that is my review for Star Wars Episode 8, The Last Jedi. I give it a B plus. That's my grade for Star Wars The Last Jedi. And that'll be it for this video. Thank you all so much for watching. I will catch you all in the next video. Peace.